We all talk about how we want our homes and cities to be more sustainable. What does sustainability even mean? What does green or environmentally conscious building mean? I am Yacob Arsano. I'm an architect and a climate engineer. I'm currently conducting my doctoral study at MIT, trying to bring simple, sustainable design solutions to builders, architects, and the general public all around the world. What environmentally conscious building means has become very important, mainly because we care a lot about mindful living and protecting the climate. But there is a situation we haven't even considered. There have been lots of advances in technologies in the building industry. And the assumption is that, in the name of modernity, we should apply all those advances everywhere, all the time. So what was scarcely imaginable a few decades ago in terms of regulating the climate has become a reality. For example, we can bring air conditioning to the desert, we can bring heat to the coldest part of the Arctic, and more people can be more comfortable. But that leads to an increased consumption of energy and material, and all that contributes to global warming and climate change, and we aren't paying enough attention to it. Think about it. Before the 20th century, before the discovery of air conditioning units, climate-responsive design that relied on passive strategies and vernacular construction was the norm. People opened windows to bring in fresh air and cool their buildings. Insulation materials were used in building facades to keep heat inside the building when it's cold outside, and breathing earth walls were used to keep spaces cool when it's hot. Now, in the name of technological advancement, we have gotten away from what we knew in the pre-industrial times. Even though I come from an institute that's meant to advance science, I think this is an instance where the good old days actually hold the key to the future. I first decided to study architecture in my home country, Ethiopia, and that's where I learned about one fascinating definition of architecture. It's the nexus of philosophy, art, and science. And I see the need to inject more science into architecture. Through my experience both in academia and practice, it's clear to me that we have a real problem, because right now, climate and human comfort inside buildings is impacting not just the humans in those buildings, but the climate itself. And we're ignoring all that. This has huge repercussions that we're only beginning to see. We have to stop building climate-agnostic buildings that require large amounts of material and energy. Here is an example. Now, if we look at buildings in the north and the south, they look completely similar, despite the fact that they are located in different climates. Buildings in hot climates, such as Mumbai, have similar technologies with ones located in cold climates, such as Boston, or temperate climates, such as London or Addis Ababa. And that's crazy. The desire to make better buildings is what inspired me to specialize in sustainable building design. And MIT is where I found the right program with a generous research support. With my advisor, Professor Christoph Reinhardt, we're building a simple open source web tool called Klima Plus. The tool gives recommendations on a set of sustainable design solutions for your building, and you only need very few inputs for that. You only need the location of your building and the building program. We give you suggestions on how to use natural ventilation more effectively rather than using mechanical conditioning. Additional recommendations are given on the construction, on the thermal mass and the insulation. Thanks to advancement in data science, we now have climate data for over 10,000 locations online. And that means now we can conduct studies in African and Asian context in a scale that was not possible before. And we know that we need the largest impact in locations where there would be high urbanization, such as what's happening in Asia and Africa. According to the UN report, 2/3 of world population is expected to live in cities by 2030. and urban population in developing countries is going to double. With Climate Plus, we have a never before opportunity to design with climate responsive design. Through science, we help protect the environment and the climate, and we help building owners save money because they will. To further maximize impact and access, in collaboration with the MIT Energy Initiative, we're building a course which would be part of an online MicroMasters program. Soon, a designer in X or an engineer in Y would be able to design and build with more sustainable buildings. Look, I know we're all from MIT, and we all always want to make things better. So you probably would like to learn more about simple strategies to make your home more sustainable, or you might want to learn more about the online course we offer. If that's you, come find me at the reception. I have a lot to tell you. Thank you.